Did you know you can quickly unsubscribe from emails in Gmail by searching the word unsubscribe in the search bar? Learn this and four more of my favorite tips to clean up your inbox in 2024. Hey friends, I'm Tasia Custody, and it's time to clear the clutter in Gmail in 2024 and hit inbox zero, or at least inbox zen. So tip number one, quickly unsubscribe from mailing lists. And there are a couple of ways to do this. Gmail does a really good job of helping you quickly unsubscribe by simply hovering over the marketing email or distribution list, and you'll get a handy unsubscribe option. If you don't have this option or it's taking too long to do this manually, all you need to do is use our handy dandy Gmail search bar and search the word unsubscribe. Hit enter. Blammo! Every email that contains the word unsubscribe will automatically appear for you. Now you can more quickly review what email lists you'd like to unsubscribe from. The caveat here, at least in the beginning of 2024, is that Gmail does not allow you to bulk unsubscribe yet. You'd need a third-party plugin for that, but there aren't any that I would recommend to you right now. Moving on to tip number two, archive emails in bulk. And keep in mind, archiving is different than deleting. So if you've got a lot of emails from one sender that are creating clutter in your inbox, once again, use the search box in the top of your Gmail to search for the email address of that sender. And again, let's narrow down that search by clicking on the filter option and adding that email address in the from section. So we only want to view emails from that email address. From here, we can click Create Filter. At the top, all we have to do is select Skip the Inbox, archive it. So emails from this sender won't even hit your inbox and create clutter for you. They'll be moved to archive instead. When you click Create Filter, any existing emails from that sender are instantly removed from your inbox. And if you're wondering, well, where do archived emails go in Gmail? They are also added to your all mail label. So you could head to that label from your main menu on the left of Gmail and find all of the emails there. Not only can you archive in bulk, but you can delete emails in bulk too. So tip number three is to bulk delete emails in Gmail. This is one of the most satisfying things. So here's how to bulk delete emails in Gmail. There are, of course, a couple of ways to do this. I think the easiest way is just a couple clicks. Click on that Select All toggle near the top to select all emails on the page. Once you select all emails using the toggle, you'll be informed at the top that you've selected all emails on the page, but you can select all conversations in your primary inbox. You'd simply click on that to get rid of every last email in your entire inbox. So if you truly want to bulk delete emails in Gmail, this is the quickest way. But you probably don't want to delete every last email in Gmail. So this trick works in each filtered inbox in Gmail. Here's what I mean. So remember how we just went into our all mail? Let's go into that again, and this time click the Select All toggle at the top. See our message now? It's all 50 conversations on this page, or all conversations in all mail, not your inbox, but anything in all mail. So again, let's head to sent and toggle these on. And now look, it's just a bulk delete action for the sent items now. You can also use your filters to bulk delete as well. So you can filter this however you want. Back in our search bar at the top, maybe you want to bulk delete all emails from a specific email address. You can just search for that email address and either select all right from those results, or you could use that same filter in the search bar to filter to emails only from that email address. Then you select all and delete them all in one go. Or you could filter by unread messages. So in your search bar at the top, type in is:unread, hit enter, boom. All your unread emails will come up. Here it's the same steps. You'd click on the Select All box and you can delete per page or simply select all conversations that match this search. So you can search and filter down to bulk delete emails in Gmail to whatever works for you. But remember, once you move items to the trash, they will sit there for 30 days. So from your trash, you can recover an email and move it back to your inbox. You can leave them sit there for 30 days, or you can select the option at the top to empty trash now. Once you do that, these emails are gone forever. Goodbye. By the way, if you want any more details on how to create and use filters in Gmail or how to create labels in Gmail, I've got a ton of videos on that listed for you in the description below. And if you're liking this video so far, please remember to give it a like and subscribe to my channel for, can you believe it, even more content like this. And with that, tip number 4 to clean up your inbox is to find and delete large files in Gmail. This is great for not only aesthetically cleaning up your inbox, but for clearing space in Gmail too. We're once again going to use our search bar at the top of Gmail. To quickly find large files that could be creating clutter and taking up storage space, just search file name, colon, and then the file type. So common file types that take up space are like PNGs or MP4 files. Hit enter to search for all emails containing that file type. Alternatively, you could search by file size as well. So in the same way we did our last search, we're gonna utilize the search bar, but this time we're gonna type larger, colon, and then the file size. So maybe we wanna find files that are larger than, I don't know, 10 megabytes or 15 megabytes, whatever it is for you, put that number in here. Hit enter to search, and bingo bango, there are all of our emails with large file sizes. I've added those search parameters for you in the description below so you can quickly copy and paste and customize them however you need. And with that, we've come to tip number 5 to clean up your inbox, report spam. Now, I will admit, Gmail does an excellent job of doing this automatically for you and having it skip your inbox, but occasionally things squeak by. If this happens, all you need to do is click that checkbox to the left of the email and then click the report spam icon. It's in the same spot near the top if you've opened that email up too, by the way. Once you've marked something as spam, it's not likely to hit your inbox again. So this is a really important step when it comes to cleaning up your inbox. Rather than simply deleting it and then keep receiving emails from that sender, just report it as spam so Gmail knows to not clutter up your inbox with it. Now with that said, I also check my spam folder every now and again to make sure that nothing has been flagged as spam that should actually be in my primary inbox. If that's happened to you and you need to move something from your spam folder or anywhere in your inbox, you can simply drag and drop that email to the desired location. So again, as another example, say you're in your inbox and something landed in your promotions tab, but you actually want that in your primary inbox, just drag it and drop it over. It's really that easy. Gmail will do its best to remember this selection for you as well. So just like with what you've marked as spam. Remember, I've got, I don't know, a million other Gmail videos for you. So if you want even more Gmail tips and tricks, make sure you follow all those links in the description below. Happy clutter-free inbox. So those are my tips to clean up your Gmail inbox in 2024. And now I want to hear from you. What was your favorite tip and why? Let everyone know in the comments below. As always, thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, well, I want to know. So give it a like, a share, or leave that comment below. You can click right about here to subscribe to my channel. And ooh, look at that. Here and here for even more Gmail tips. You know you wanna. Thanks for watching. See you next time.